Okay, let's see what is a choreogram. Choreogram, basically it is a software tool to assess the care risk of a patient. So we can assess care risk by using various methods. Usually we conduct examination on patient's saliva, patient's salivary flow rate, its buffering capacity, the amount of plaque, the exposure to fluoride, the brushing frequency, and the sugar exposure, the frequency of sugar, consistency of sugar. Since dental caries is a multifactorial disease, the prediction of this risk is a bit complicated. It is not easy to predict because there are many factors involved in caries development. So, choreogram is the so a choreogram will look like this. It looks like a pie. It is a pie chart basically with five colors: green, yellow, light blue, red, and dark blue. Each color represent a certain section of predictors, that is the components of caries formation, and the green one is a different thing that I'll tell you later. So it is invented by a scientist named D. Bradhall. So D. Bradhall invented the choreogram to estimate the caries risk of a person. So choreogram is the most accurate tool to predict the caries risk of a person. So it is a risk estimation of dental caries. Since caries is a multifactorial disease, it's not easy to predict a caries development. So all these sections, that is all four sections, we just keep the green section apart. The rest four sections are the components or the factors which involved in the caries formation. So it includes all the multifactorial components of a dental caries. So by asking the questions related to caries formation, we will quantify it, that is we will give numbers for each question's answers, and we'll add up the numbers and we'll compute it because it's a software, and finally we get a percentage. The whole pie will be 100%, so each part of the pie will be certain percentage. The green will be certain percentage, yellow, light blue, red, and dark blue all becomes percentage. So finally what we have to find is the percentage of green section. So that is what important. So green section will not be created at the first because we are asking questions related to the other four sectors, that is yellow, light blue, red, and dark blue. So depending upon the answers, it may become a big section or a small section, ultimately produces a smaller green section or a bigger green section. Okay. So here we can see the all five sections, that is five parts of a pie chart with certain percentage. This is just an hypothetical example. So let's see what is that green color. Green color is actual chance of avoid new cavities. The green color indicates that the percentage protective power of person against caries. If the pie chart is entirely green, that is 100%, that means the person has zero chance to develop new caries. If the person's green section is 0% instead of 100%, the person has no protection against dental caries and he may have a lot of caries. So green section says the protection against dental caries. So how the green section is getting into that percentage depends on the all other four percentage, that is other sectors. So let's see the dark blue sector. So the dark blue sector is diet. So in this section we ask questions about diet content, whether it is sticky or not sticky, and the frequency, whether patient consumes more cariogenic food less frequent or more frequent. So depending upon this answer will give marks or will count the response. That is, dark blue is diet. So we ask diet content and diet frequency. So since it's a multifactorial, the caries multifactorial disease, caries is a multifactorial disease, so we highlight all the components, that is diet, microbes, personal host factors, agent factors and environmental factors. So the dark blue is diet, then the red sector is bacteria. So we have to count the amount of plaque by using any plaque indices and mutant streptococci. We can take a swab and count the bacteria, or we can use any indices to count the plaque. So the red sector is bacteria, so we count the amount of plaque by using any plaque indices and the amount of streptococci using any swab test. So the next thing is light blue, which is of susceptibility, where we assess the flow rate program, salivary secretion and buffer capacity. So as we were seeing in dark blue, if the patient diet content is more cariogenic and diet frequency is more cariogenic, the dark blue sector will be more. Similarly, the patient's amount of plaque and the colonies of microbacteria is more, the red sector will be more. Okay, it will be a bigger size. And similarly, the light blue, which is seeing the flow rate program, if patient is taking any flow rate toothpaste or any other supplements of flow rate, and patient's saliva flow is adequate or inadequate, and buffering capacity is adequate or inadequate. If it is going inadequate or less amount of flow rate patient is taking, the more chances of caries, that is the light blue sector will be more. Okay, if the patient is having a good amount of flow rate exposure and good salivary flow and good buffering capacity, the light blue sector will be less. So the last one is yellow sector, which is circumstances. So we check the past caries experience and other related diseases which can cause dental caries. So we check the past caries experience by using any DMFT indices and any other systemic diseases which can create chances of dental caries. So we ask all these four sectors questions, not the green sector. The green sector will be made out of these four sectors answers. Okay. So you can see a cariogram software. So it is a software in a computer. So you can see the questions like on the right side here, caries experience, related disease, diet content, diet frequency, plaque amount, streptococcus, flow rate program, saliva secretion, buffer capacity. So all these are different questions of the four sectors we were talking about, that is light blue, dark blue, yellow and red. So we can say that the diet content and frequency related to dark blue, the plaque amount and mutant streptococci related to red sector, and the light blue susceptibility, that is saliva secretion, buffering capacity and flow rate program belong to the susceptibility of light blue. The yellow section, that is circumstances, that is past dental caries experience and related disease. So we ask questions, so you can see the numbers which is put here 0 to 3 and 0 to 2. Similarly, so you can see here the numbers 0 to 3. You don't worry about this because we are not going to write in detail about the software. We are going to write about the concept and the five colors. So just to give a much insight to this Karyogram software, so we have this option 0, 2, 3, 0, 2, 2. So we enter all the values related to the questions responses. So we get something like this. This is a hypothetical example. So after putting all the values, we get something like this. You can see the response 2, 1, 2, 3, like that. So we get percentage. Ultimately we get percentage. We are getting 32% of diet, 26% of bacteria, and 13% of susceptibility, and 12% of circumstances. How we get this percentage is, it depends upon the patient's response to questions related to each sector. The green sector is not by the result of questions. It is how it is because we are adding all these four sectors, that is 12 plus 13 plus 26 plus 32, it becomes 83. And we subtract it from 100 because the all pie chart will be 100%. So 100 minus the remaining four sectors, that is 83, becomes 17%. So this patient has 17% chance of avoiding new dental cavities. The patient's caries risk is high because the red section is pretty much very narrow compared to the entire pie chart. The entire pie chart is 100%. When it is 100%, patient has zero chance of caries. Since it is 17% compared to 100, the patient has more chances of caries, and patient's caries risk is high. So this is all about Karyogram. So it is what we have to do in exam. We have to draw the pie chart with five colors, and you can hypothetically give some percentage, and each four sectors apart from green you have to mention the questions, and you have to write it as the green sector means chance to avoid of dental caries or the caries risk. Bigger the green sector, less caries risk. Lesser the green sector, more caries risk, that is chance to avoid dental caries. That is all about Karyogram. Okay, thank you.